Hello everyone, this is Econ Mind YouTube channel. This presentation is on business cycle and how it can be used to explain COVID-19 pandemic and its impact on economic activities. Actually, business cycle is a model that can be used to explain some economic concepts. If we try to define what is business cycle, it is a diagram that shows the change in real output of a country with time. According to this diagram, peak is the highest output in a certain time period and trough is the lowest output in a certain time period. The time period from peak to trough consists of two parts as recessionary time period and depressionary time period. These are the main features of the time period from peak to trough. Real output or real GDP gradually decreases. Unemployment level of the economy increases and there is a tendency of decrease in prices, so there is a deflationary impact in the economy. During this time period from trough to peak, the opposite behavior of the above features can be seen. So, real output or GDP will increase, inflationary impact can be seen and the employment level gradually increases. Most of the countries' economies have faced this fluctuation of the output with time. Even the entire world has passed different phases of business cycle. Here are some examples for crisis situations or the time periods where we were moving toward the trough. One is from 1929 to 1939, the Great Depression. Next one is world economic crisis that began in 2007 and went for several years, at least for 2013. As far as the Great Depression and World Economic Crisis concerned, the time period which we are having here, I mean the time period where COVID-19 impact is there, it's going to be a massive destruction compared to the previous two stages. That is mainly because of several reasons. One reason is, when we consider the previous impacts, they does not affect the entire world in a small time period. Already you can see most of the countries' economic activities are gradually decreasing. The strong economies are in a recessionary or depressionary time period, and we don't know time period is needed to recover because the health problem or the hazard has not recovered yet. Even the health hazard is recovered, the economic impact will go for a longer time period in the future. When we consider these type of crisis situations, the impact should be studied using different techniques such as macroprudential analysis. Like that here, I attempt to explain business cycle and how these type of crisis situations can affect. Therefore, I am going to tell some simple reasons you can see in the world very easily. One is, most of the countries have locked down certain areas of the entire country. Then it is very easy for us to understand that there can be a huge impact on economic activities for the entire world. Secondly, some of the firms, companies have already stopped their business activities. Developed countries as well as developing countries have to spend large amount of money for the current expenditure. That means the amount they have for investment expenditure will be smaller and it has a negative impact on economic growth. Most of the stock markets have been already severely affected because of this crisis. Tourism as an industry in a crucial situation. Over the board transaction, I mean export import related industries and trade activities have stuck in more than 1 year's time period, and it is still continuing or still it is going on. So the end story cannot be explained, or its strength or the burden of the economic activities based on that one cannot be predicted so far. because the population of the world in a crucial situation, not a single country or region or part of continent. This is for all the continents. That's why we have to understand that this is a recessionary time period or depressionary time period, and we are moving toward the trough, and it's very clear we have not moved to the trough situation yet. Then its strength we don't know, and it has been not analyzed yet. So we are waiting and trying to understand what is really going to happen in the next moment, next day, in the next year. Right, okay, I'm going to wind up this presentation, keeping a question for you, because the next event of the countries or the world is unpredictable. In my next presentation, I try to explain how the countries use counter cycle policies such as expansionary monetary policy and expansionary fiscal policy to overcome this crisis situation. Okay, stay with me to understand the subject facts better and theories better in relation to business cycle and COVID-19 pandemic. And before my next presentation, you can comment, you can do suggestions related to the theoretical facts or something else, and I hope that you understand something with my presentation, and thank for watching this channel.